Hi everyone, again it's me, your math teacher Jello. For today's video, let's have another example on how to graph inverse functions. Another example, illustrate the graph of the given 1-to-1 function and its inverse. So ang given natin dito guys ay f of x equals x to the third power. Okay, so first, ang gagawin natin dito, let's find the inverse of this given function. Okay, mag-solution muna tayo. So f of x equals x cube. So, kung matatandaan nyo, sa previous video natin, yung f of x, gagawin natin y. Okay? Replace f of x with y. And then, copy the equation, x cube. And then, second step, or step number 2, interchange the position of x and y. So, y becomes x. And then, x becomes y. Of course, do not forget the exponent. And then, solve for y in terms of x. Or solve the equation for y. So, this case, we have ratio to third power. At para mawala yan, guys, ang gagawin natin ay cube root of both sides. So, get the cube root of both sides. Okay, so makakancel out to. Yan. Ang matitira na lang dito guys ay y and then equals the cube root of x. Okay. And then, sa last step natin or step number 4, replace y with f inverse of x. So magiging f inverse of x equals cube root of x. So, which means, yung f of x equals x cube, magiging f inverse of x equals cube root of x. So, ito yung kabaligtaran niya or yung inverse nito. Okay? So, meaning, ito yung gagamitin natin dito sa second table of values. Ito yung inverse niya. So, f inverse of x equals x cube root of x. Nakuha ba guys? Ganun lang kasimple. Okay. So, ngayon, ang gagawin natin dyan guys, using table of values, okay, mag-assign tayo ng numbers. So, let's use negative 2, negative 1, 0, positive 1, and positive 2. So, para ma-solve natin yung y values, yan, isa-substitute natin yung x values, negative 2 up to positive 2, in place of x sa original equation natin. Okay? So, when x equals negative 2, negative 2 to the third power, this becomes negative 8. Okay? Kasi, negative 2 times negative 2, positive 4 times negative 2, which is negative 8. Okay, when x is equal to negative 1, negative 1 to the third power, of course, the answer is still negative 1, right? Hindi siya magiging positive kasi ang exponent natin ay odd number. Okay, when the base is negative and the exponent is odd number, it will give us a negative answer pa rin. Okay, so when x equals 0, of course, 0 yan. Kasi 0 cube is equal to 0. When x equals 1, raise to the third power. So, positive 1 yan still. And then, 2 to the third power, that is equal to positive 8. Okay. So, dito guys, makakuha natin yung domain tsaka range or yung x and y values ng inverse natin. Okay. So, ito yung original function natin guys. So, yung x values natin dito guys, yung domain, magiging range natin dito. Okay? So, this is now equal to negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, positive 2. And then, yung y naman natin dito guys, magiging domain natin dito. O yung range dito magiging domain natin dito. Okay? So, this becomes negative 8, Yan. Next, negative 1, 0, 1, 8. Or simply, interchange the position of x and y. Ganun lang kasimple. Okay. So now, guys, meron na tayong coordinates dito. Okay. Ipa-plot na natin yan sa Cartesian plane natin. Okay. I'm pretty sure na marunong kayong mag-plot ng coordinates using our Cartesian coordinate plane. Okay. So first, let us graph the original function. I will be using the red pen. It indicates na ito yung original function natin. So mamaya gagamit ako ng another color para sa inverse nun. Okay? So negative 2, negative 8. So your x is negative 2. Ayan. And then your y is negative 8. So ito yung negative 8 natin. So pagtatapatin lang natin yan, guys. So dapat accurate yung magiging graph natin, ha? Okay. So negative 2, negative 8. Okay. Negative 1, negative 1. Your x is negative 1. Your y is also negative 1. So nandito siya, guys. And then 0, 0. So parehong nasa origin yan. And 1, 1. Your x is 1. Your y is also 1. So ito siya, guys. And then 2, 8. Your x is 2. Your y is 8. Yan. And then, after we plot the following coordinates, or yung ordered pair natin na tawag natin, itutrace na natin yung mga coordinate, or yung mga dots na yan. Okay? So, ito yan, guys. So, ito yung graph ng original function natin. Okay? Ito ay, maybe sulat ko na lang dito, f of x equals x cube. Okay? Next. So, ito naman yung inverse function natin. So, let's graph or locate the following points using our Cartesian coordinate plane. So, negative 8, negative 2. Your x is negative 8. Tingin kayo kay negative x-axis. Ito yun, guys. So, negative 8. And then, your y is negative 2. Ito yung negative y-axis natin. So, ito siya. Pagtatapatin nyo lang yan, guys. Yun. So, negative 8, negative 2. Next, your x is negative 1. Y is also negative 1. X is negative 1. Y equals negative 1. So, ito siya, guys. Next, 0, 0. Okay, nandito rin siya. And then, we have 1, 1. Your x is 1, your y is 1. So, nandito rin siya. And then, 8, 2. Your x is 8, your y is positive 2. So, nandito siya, guys. Okay. So, naintindihan ba? So, now, ang goal naman natin dito ay i-trace natin or i-connect natin yung mga points na yan. Okay? Or yung ordered pair. So, let's trace. So, guys, pag ganito siya, ayan. So, dito, guys, kung mapapansin natin, okay, yung ito ay graph ng inverse, no? So, f inverse of x equals cube root of x. So, ito, guys, kung mapapansin natin, yung inverse natin, yung graph ng inverse function natin ay reflection siya ng original function or vice versa. Okay. So, with respect to line y equals x. So, nandito siya, guys. Kung mapapansin natin, reflection or mirror, no? Yan. Ito yung tinatawag nating axis of symmetry. So, ito yung tinatawag nating y is equal to x. Okay? May question ba, guys? Okay, kung meron kayong natutunan sa video ng ito, paki-like and share. Thank you for watching.